Hello. Good evening, everybody. My name is Darrell, and this is Seah Huan Yuh. I don't know if that's how he pronounces his name, but that's how I pronounce his name. He's here to play for us three pieces, two which have been arranged for solo violin and orchestra. They were originally written for a piano duet, and they come from a bunch of so-called Hungarian dances by the German composer Johannes Brahms. He will be playing the pieces that are traditionally known as numbers 2 and 5. Let's ask him a little bit about why he chose those pieces. Juan, did you choose those pieces? You did, right?
Those are the ones available in your life.
Yeah. Right. I guess that's always a good reason, yes. Right, okay, thank you. And there is one more, yes. But wait, before I go into that, I'm going to ask you, how do you relate to these Hungarian dances? You're not Hungarian, and neither are you German, but you do play the violin. But how does that translate? How does this gypsy feeling translate into playing the violin?
A little bit of gypsy violin. I think the violin is universal. So the gypsies play on this violin, and Brahms is a little bit Hungarian, right? German. Hungarian.
I don't think so. That long beard, I think, tells me he's German.
Yeah, he's German. But so anyway, he wrote this with Hungarian influences. It's really a question mark. So and the violin is one of the instruments that the gypsies use. So that's how much I try to relate to it.
Okay.
I'm 100% Singaporean, proud to be one. And you know,
and that's exactly why he's the right person to bring out those Hungarian flavors in the Hungarian dances. And then there's another piece for violin and orchestra. It's actually a song by an Argentinian musician, come poet, come artist, come whatever. His name is Carlos Gardel, and he wrote this, I think, in the 1920s. Yeah, it's called, and you probably know it if you're a movie buff. It's called Tango por una Cabeza, which actually means tango for the head of a horse. It's a funny title, you might say, and why the head of a horse? I don't really know, but I think. When I meet an Argentinian, I'm going to ask, what is the significance of a horse's head? Do you know?
I can help with that.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah. Please tell them.
So this Gardel, he's singing about, horse racing is popular in Argentina. And so he's a singer who always complains that, by a head of a horse, I lost again. I lost money again. And in the second stanza, he said, by a head of a horse, I lost the woman that I love again. So it's always, just slightly behind. But interestingly enough, the title is by a head. The of a horse is implied. It's not in the title. It's by a head. So I could see from the other side, which means I win by a head of a horse rather than I lose. So it really depends on how you look at it. But the original meaning means he lost. And he asked, this big question about life, why do I keep doing it again and again? Every week when I go to the horse racing, I see this very nice little looking pony and I say, let me bet my money on that little pony again. And so this goes on forever. And so that's a song about, it's a very, very popular song in Schindler's List, in
Scent of a Woman.
True Lies, Scent of a Woman. Yeah. And it's enjoy it. So this composer, John Williams, the guy who wrote Star Wars music, Indiana Jones, he arranged it for solo violin orchestra, and I'm very happy because it's one of my dream pieces to play with orchestra. It's very difficult, and SSO has very generously just ordered it. It's very expensive score, it's a great score, and they produce a glorious sound. We had fun doing it. Yeah? So enjoy the pieces. I think that's enough.
So Hungarian dances, two of them, and then tango.
Thank you.